Hello, and welcome to Frontier Community Access Television. Thank you for joining us tonight for today's girls soccer matchup between the Frontier Redhawks and Greenfield Green Wave. We will be right back in a couple minutes with starting lineup and the senior ceremony.
Good evening, and welcome to the Frontier Redhawk Girls Soccer Senior Night against the Greenfield Green Wave. We would like to begin our program tonight by acknowledging the seniors from Greenfield. The first senior from Greenfield is Michaela Valente. The second senior from Greenfield is Ava Widello. And the third senior from Greenfield is Asmina Sikajimin. And now let's begin our senior program for Frontier. This is a note from Coach. I've had the privilege to coach all seven and for some to be their sixth grade math teacher. This is a group of seniors that is a special group. They work hard on and off the field. They are extremely motivated and can be forced to be reckoned with. Our first senior tonight is Caroline Crocker. Caroline is walking out with her parents, Tina and Jamie, and her brother, Nick. Caroline is planning on studying nursing after high school. Like Sophie, Caroline is an easygoing, chill person, but on the field, she is able to be one of the fastest players and has proven to be an excellent defender. Our second senior is Chloe Felton Emmerich. Walking with Chloe is her mom, Kathy Felton. Chloe's plan after high school is to go to college for fashion design and minor in Spanish. Chloe does a great dance to the song Earth, Wind, and Fire September. Just ask her sixth grade self. Our next senior is Kylie LaFord. Kylie is walking out with her parents, Sue and Derek LaFord. Kylie is planning on attending community college for 2 years and hopes to get a minor in physical education and a major in business. I have no doubt her debating skills and passion will help her with the business degree. Our next senior is Sophie Leone. Walking out with Sophie are her parents, Olivia and Frank. Sophie is planning on attending college to study psychology. Off the field, I always see Sophie as calm and relaxed, but on the field, she is fast and aggressive and goes all out. Our next senior is Anna Petrin. Walking out with Anna are her parents, Shannon and Mike. Anna is planning on attending a four-year college to major in nursing or a physician's assistant program. Anna, I will be missing all of the many conversations that we have had, mostly me listening and you talking. Our next senior for tonight is Sydney Tor. Sydney is walking out with her mom, Eva, and her sister, Zoe. Sydney would like to go to college in a faraway land to study engineering and humanities. Sydney has a strong work ethic that I have no doubt will continue in order for her to reach her goals. Our last senior this evening is Katie Wells Robinson. Walking out with Katie are her parents, Rebecca and Sean. Katie is looking to attend Bay Path College, and she would like to study something in the medical field. She is hoping to play either soccer or basketball at the college level. Katie also is on the verge of having 1,000 saves this season. Sorry, 100. Thank you to all the seniors for what you've done for the program. You will all be missed. And now, the starting lineup for tonight's game. The starting lineup for Greenfield is number 21, Michaela Valente. Number 2, Ava Widello. Number 6, Anna Bicala. Number 7, Carly Blanchard. Number 8, Bianca Reynolds. Number 10, Eldarina Sikajinen. Number 11, Asmina Sikajinen. Number 13, Taylor Bergeron. Number 16, Suhani Patel. Number 17, Indy Merrill. And number 18, Holly Babineau. And now the starting lineup for the Red Hawks. Number 0, Katie Wells Robinson. Number 5, Sydney Tor. Number 9, Sophie Leone. Number 13, Caroline Crocker. Number 15, Kylie LaFord. Number 21, Chloe Felton Emmerich. Number 19, Anna Petrin. Number 14, Maddie Bennett. Number 7, Hannah Mackin. Number 18, Josie Fosno. And number 6, Maddie Fagan.
Hello and welcome to Frontier Community Access Television. I'm your host, Mason Smith, and we're joined tonight by our guest host, Aiden Weiss, from the Frontier varsity football team. Tonight's matchup is girls soccer, Frontier Redhawks against Greenfield Green Wave. Frontier is 8-5-2 coming into this game, and Green Wave is 7-7-1. And we're underway here at Frontier. Keeping the ball on the near side of the field. Green Wave in possession. Got a couple Red Hawks around the ball. Nice pass.
That was a good pass.
And Frontier's pushing the ball up the field, and it's going to get kicked out of bounds by number 2. That's Ava Widello for Green Wave. Nice long throw in there from Frontier. It's going to get into the goalie box. Shot on goal gets stopped. Green Wave goalie is going to punt it past the midfield line. Header forward from Anna Petrin, I believe. Green Wave in possession of the ball now. Nice pass ahead of the defenders there on the near side of the field. Number 11 for Green Wave. Shot on goal goes right over and through the field goal posts. So that's going to be a goal kick for Frontier. Katie Wells Robinson is the goalie for Frontier, and Anna Petrin is going to take the kick. Gets knocked down by Josie Fosno. Kicked up the sideline. Pass to the middle of the field to Sydney Torr. She passes it up. It's going to get intercepted by a couple Green Wave players. Greenfield's going to retain possession, taking it up the near side of the field. Ball gets stolen by Frontier. Passed up to midfield. Torres back with the ball over to Fosno. She's going to get past a couple defenders. And the pass goes right by Sydney Torr. Green Wave has it. They're fighting for the ball over there now. Pass up by Frontier. Green Wave has it back now. And there's a nice kick over the head of the Greenfield defenders. Frontier's going to try and keep possession of that. They're fighting for it. Green Wave's going to get it back. They're going up the far side of the field now. Frontier's got the ball, trying to get it closer, but no, they're going to get stopped by a Green Wave defender who kicks it up the sideline. Pass intercepted by Green Wave. Centering pass.
That was a good pass, very good pass.
Right to the top of the goal box. Little shove there by Frontier. Gets it back to midfield. Nice pass up ahead of the defenders. Frontier's going to be there for it. They're going to center it. Header towards the goal. Gets grabbed by the goalie. So Frontier's had two shots on goal now. Green Wave back with the ball now. Looks for a pass. There it is. Gets by a defender, gets by two. Forward pass to the sideline. Top of the goal box. Pass gets knocked down. There's a shot on goal. Gets stopped by Katie. That was a great kick. That was as Mina kicking Jenny. I'm definitely saying that wrong. Frontier has the ball now. It's going to get by a couple defenders to the goalie, who punts it away. Gets knocked down by Frontier. Frontier's going to try and push it back. Got a little triangle forming there, and they're going to get past a couple defenders. Josie Fosno in the near corner tries to center it right in front of the goal. They've got a couple players right there. Green Wave player gets shoved down. Sydney Torr with a nice kick at the goal, but it gets stopped.
Got physical there for a second.
Yeah. Green Wave with the ball about midfield. They're going to push it up the near sideline. It's a foot race up the sideline. They're getting to the corner now. They're in the corner. What a great move there. Nice centering pass right into the goalie box. And there's a penalty. Offsides, I assume. Yeah, that looks like what it was.
Might have been a handball, actually.
Oh, yeah, that's a good bet. Yeah, a little forewarning, folks. I'm not too familiar with soccer penalties. Nice little pass above a Green Wave defender to Josie Fosnow, but she can't handle it. Goes out of bounds. So it's going to be Green Wave throw-in. And the ball's going to go roll out of bounds. So now it's Frontier throw-in.
Oh, right off the side of the head.
Yeah. Sydney Torb pass to the far side of the field. Green Wave's going to kick it past a couple defenders, see if they can get anything. Looks like they aren't going to. Nice pass there. A lot of air time. A couple Green Wave forwards going to fight for it, but Frontier's going to get it back around midfield. Pass up to Fosno, and an offside call right there. So Green Wave's going to have the ball. Little kick right on the sideline. Ball gets knocked down by Sydney Torr. And hit out of bounds by Green Wave player. Fosno's going to take the throw-in. Ball gets kicked up. Header there, midfield. From Frontier. Forward pass, just over her head. On a whiff kick there. Might give Frontier an opportunity. But it looks like it's going to go out of bounds for a Red Hawk throw-in. Frontier still got the ball. Try to pass up to Fosno. No one's there. Kick up gets knocked down by a Green Wave player. Bennett gets a centering pass. Back to Bennett. She's got a shot, but it gets deflected, and Green Wave is going to kick it out of bounds right by the corner, so it's going to be a throw-in. Not a corner kick. Oh, and that's an offside call.
They're keeping a nice triangle formation going on, Frontier.
Green Wave's going to try and make something happen here. Frontier's going to get a pass up, and it goes straight to the Green Wave goalie. It's going to punt it down to midfield. Frontier's going to kick it right back to midfield. Sydney Torr fighting for the ball there. Gets back to Green Wave, who's going to try and pass it up. Gets deflected by a Frontier defender. Crossfield pass. Gets stopped, but then it rolls out of bounds. Frontier throwing gets knocked down by a Green Wave player. Sydney Torr has it. She tries to pass it up. Green Wave's got the ball back now. Nice pass up to the forward there. They're at midfield now. Frontier with the ball. Forward pass. up in front of the defenders. Fosno's running. She's going to get to the ball. She's got a shot on the goal. It's going to get deflected. Nice play there by number 7. That was Carly Blanchard for Green Wave. Nice defensive play. Well, we've got just... We've been playing for about 10 minutes now, folks.
Things are always starting to get intense a little bit, I would say.
Yeah. Corner kick. Right over the goalie's hands. Gets knocked down by Green Wave. Cleared out of the goal box, but Sydney Tor's there to bat it down. Centering pass by Frontier. Green Wave's going to get it, though. Fosno's fighting for it. It's going to go out of bounds. And it's going to stay Frontier's ball. There's a nice throw-in. Good awareness there. Tor's going to head it back forward. Frontier's still fighting for it. Right on the edge of the goal box. But Green Wave's going to clear it out. We're back at midfield now. Try and pass it forward, but it's going to go out of bounds off of a Frontier player. Forward pass by Frontier. Sydney Tor.
What a move.
Gets by the defenders. Nice shot there. Stopped by the goalie. Tor kicks it forward. Off of the punt. Number 11 for Green Wave is going to give them a nice centering pass. And they're going to try and pass it right back to her. They do. That was a great play right there. She's going to keep it just in bounds. Another centering pass. Oh, gets right by them. That was a great setup right there. Wow.
Very good communication.
Well, Frontier's got the ball. And they've got it past midfield. They've got a breakaway opportunity, it looks like. Shot on goal is good. All right.
What a goal.
That was quite a turn of events right there. Well, that's our first goal of the game, folks. Frontier's goal, so they're going to be in the lead 1-0. And that was Madeline Bennett on the goal.
That was a great pass there.
Oh, yeah, it was. And it was right after Green Wave had a great opportunity to score on Frontier. They just turned it around, brought it all the way back.
She stayed right on side until the last moment.
So Green Wave's going to have the ball now. Taylor Bergeron fighting for the ball.
Goal scored by Maddie Bennett.
Green Wave's going to kick it up to Asmina. Oh my God. What a great move there. Centering pass attempt by Green Wave. Going to get intercepted by Frontier. Pass back from midfield. Pass forward. Everyone's onside.
Got a good
breakaway
now.
They've got someone up ahead. Oh, nice defense there by Green Wave. Not sure who that was. Asmina's got it back for Green Wave. Gonna see if she can make something happen. Knocks down her defender. Centering pass, but no one's there. She doesn't look too happy about it.
That was a good pass.
Yeah, right from the sideline. Pass back to Fosno. Midfield. Right through Tor's legs and Green Wave's going to kick it down header to knock it forward from Frontier. Ooh, was that right off her head?
Yeah, I think she. Yeah.
Nice.
I heard some discomfort there.
Yeah. Fosno pass to middle of the field.
She seems stolen. Like she's holding her nose too.
Yeah.
Might be bleeding.
Well, here is Mina on the sideline again. There's the centering pass she was looking for. Pass back to Ismina. She's got an opportunity here. Oh, but she's going to lose the ball. Knocked her defender over. But now Frontier's going to swarm a Greenfield player. Get the ball back. Try to pass forward. No one's there. Fosno with the ball around midfield. Pass up. And there's another great pass, and it's going too fast towards the sideline. It's going to go out of bounds. Well, I'll tell you what, Aiden, if Ismina can get her centering pass, someone in the center, Greenfield's going to get a goal pretty quickly because she's making things happen on the sideline.
Yeah, she's definitely making some moves and progressing the ball up the field a lot.
We're going to have a couple subs come in for Frontier. There's a throw-in centering pass for Frontier. They've got a player there. And the goalie's going to fall right on the ball. Michaela Valente, I believe is her name.
Ooh.
Ball's back around midfield now. Frontier with the ball. Greenfield kicks it across the field. Frontier's going to be right there waiting for it. They're going to have an opportunity here. But the goalie's just a little too quick. Scoops it up and punts it back across the field. Green Wave's going to get the ball now. Pass it up to midfield. Try a forward pass, but there's no one there. Frontier tries to pass it up. Nice little pass there to Fosno on the sideline. Ooh. Off with Widelo's head. And a nice little move there from Ismina. Going up the sideline. Barely keeping it in bounds. Beautiful centering pass. And there's a shot. Barely stopped by Wells Robinson. Oh, my God.
Dive all the way out there. Full body extension.
That was great effort by both teams right there. Beautiful setup by Ismina.
And beautiful save.
And a great, great save by Katie. So now Frontier's going to have the ball, pushing it forward, trying to get past a couple defenders. It's a foot race. They're in the corner, and it's going to go out of bounds on Frontier, it looks like. Yeah, that was Madeline Bennett again, who got the goal earlier. Oh, and she's right there. She's going to get the ball again in the goalie box, centers it. And the shot on goal is caught by the goalie. Sent back to midfield. Frontier makes a move, tries to get it forward, going to get passed back. Green Wave's going to pass it forward to Ismina, who's got center field now. She's going to make a couple moves, gets a shot on goal, and it's in. That's what Green Wave was waiting for right there.
That was a great move to cut White back into the middle.
Oh, yeah, that was beautiful. So now the score is going to be tied up. 1-1.
It's a very windy, cold day here at Frontier Regional High School.
Oh, yeah. What temperature are we rocking here? Let's check. check the weather up. 47 degrees.
Yeah, heat. Man, it's only going down. Only going down.
Got like four layers on right now.
At least you got four, I only got one.
Yeah. I mean, then you look out at the players out there, and they're wearing t-shirts and shorts. At least they got some long socks.
The main heat supply, long socks.
So the players are taking a quick break. Clock's going to stop. One of the rare times it stops in soccer.
Goal scored by Esmina Sikajanet.
They're using this time. They're using this time to stretch out, make sure they stay warm, so now their muscles get nice and tight.
Yeah, you can see them stretching each other out on the sidelines.
It's very important to keep warm in these kind of conditions, or otherwise you just get too stiff.
Yeah, you know, especially like what I think about all the time with, like, you know, when it's cold like this and you aren't wearing all that many layers and you're just standing there like the goalies are, you know, they're going to get stiff. They're going to, like what we're doing right now, you know, we're just standing there and we're just shaking. And so, you know, especially like, you know, Katie Wills-Robinson, she hasn't seen a lot of action so far in the game except for that one really good save that she had a couple minutes ago. And, you know, she's got to be, you know,
always
getting,
ready,
starting to get a little stiff at this point. It's like, oh, nice forward pass there. Up to the far sideline. Is it going to stay in? It is. Tor with the ball now for Frontier. Pass up goes right to the goalie. Valente is going to take it to the near corner of the goalie box. Kicks it. And Frontier's right there, putting pressure on the Green Wave defenders. And they've got someone right there. Open goal. Oh, my goodness. What a team play right there.
That net was wide open for Frontier to score.
That was a nice little forward pass. Got knocked down by the goalie, who couldn't get back in time. And now that's going to make the score 2-1 Frontier with, we've got just over 18 minutes left in this first half. And Green Wave's going to pass the ball up. They've got someone forward. See if they can make something happen. They pass it back to Esmina, who makes a move. But they're just getting swarmed by Red Hawks right now. Frontier, pass over a couple defenders up the sideline, and it's going to go out of bounds. So Carly Blanchard throws it in for Green Wave. Ball gets taken. Tor pass up. And there's a nice centering pass to Frontier, who's going to... Oh.
Just a little too much power put in front of it.
That was a great play right there by Valente. Just falling right on top of the ball. Centering pass from Frontier. Shot on goal, gonna get scooped right up by Valente. Gets up to the top of the box. There's the kick. Header by Green Wave. Gets passed up by Tor. And it's gonna go out of bounds, looks like. And it's going to be Green Wave's ball.
What?
There's the throw-in. Green Wave's got it on the far sideline, trying to make something happen there. They've got Redhawks all around them. And Frontier's going to get the ball back. Bennett has the ball, tries to pass up, but it's going to get kicked out of bounds by Ava Widello for Green Wave. Throw in for Frontier, gets headed back right at them. Green Wave defender headed by Frontier. Pass up, gets stopped by Frontier defender. Pass back up to midfield. Redhawks right there. Tor gets the ball around midfield and tries to pass it up. Gets taken by a couple Green Wave players. Green Wave tries to pass it to Esmina. She's not there. There's Bennett, tries to pass it up. Gets hit back. And Bennett's going to get a pass just outside the goalie box. Centers it. Oh, and just right in front of her. Oh, jeez. That was a beautiful pass right there. Just a little bit too far ahead.
They were so close to connecting that. That would have been an amazing goal.
That would have been, yeah. On the move, just, that would have been great.
Communication is definitely there, though.
Oh, yeah, it is. They're connecting when they need to. Tor passes it up. She's going to try and beat the defenders, but they're going to get to the ball before her. Ball's in the middle of the goalie box now. Pass back to the top. Shot on goal. Gets caught by the goalie. High pop fly of a kick right there. It's going to get fielded by Green Wave midfielder. Bennett's got it now. Pass forward. Frontier's right there. Shot on goal's good.
Another amazing goal. Pass through ball.
That was
Well set play.
Madeline Fagan on the goal. And I believe it was on the assist, Jillian Warden. And Madeline Fagan is only a freshman.
Mason, I tell you what, if they keep doing these nice pass-through balls, they're going to have a good night.
Frontier,
yeah. They're going to have a good night.
No, you're definitely right. They've got a lot. They've got a really great passing game. Fagan. No, but in something that I was noticing about Green Wave a couple minutes ago was they had a good opportunity on the far side of the field to make something happen, and it was just two or three midfielders on Green Wave that were just too close to each other, and they were trying to pass it around, and nothing was happening.
Yeah. I mean, if the Greenfield gets the communication there, they can definitely do some damage.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Especially with the kind of player that they have in Esmina.
Yeah.
Who has the ball right now and is speeding up the sideline. Makes a little move there on her defender. Shot on goal from far away. Gets knocked down by Wells Robinson. Oh, great save.
That was a beautiful save.
Nice long kick from Wells Robinson.
Wells Robinson is making some good saves tonight.
Oh, yeah. No, it was a long shot from Esmina. Got knocked down, and then someone else took a shot at close range, and she just...
Yeah, she got the rebound, but great. Robinson was there.
Frontier on the far sideline. Fagan gets it, top of the goalie box. They're looking for a pass. Green Wave intercepts it. Frontier's going to get it in the corner. Centering pass. Oh, just past Fagan.
The idea was there. The idea was there.
This has happened two or three times now for Frontier where they've had some great execution and then they just can't get it done right at the end. But you know what? Like, at this point in the game, they're up 3-1, folks. They can afford those kind of mistakes. Green Wave, on the other hand, they just can't, you know? Ball is going to go out of bounds on Green Wave. And we've got a couple subs coming in for both teams.
Looks like Molly Gates is coming in.
Yeah, Molly Gates coming in for Frontier. And that's Lauren Helly.
You know what I haven't seen a lot, Mason? Frontier's been doing nice, quick throw-ins. I think they're trying to keep Greenfield on the toes of their feet.
Yeah. No, I think that you're right. They're not letting them take any breaks. And that's one of the things that is a very strategic point in soccer, I think. Like, you know, trying to tire out your opponent. Because, you know, the clock doesn't stop. The plays don't really stop. There's a shot on goal. Goes right over the crossbar. But yeah, definitely. I think you're right. Frontier's on top of being up two goals. They're trying to tire out Green Wave. And we're going to have to wait and see if that works, but it's definitely
goal scored by Maddie Bennett and then the last goal was scored by Maddie Fagan.
Throw in by Esmina. So here's gonna be another throw-in by Green Wave. There didn't make a lot of progress there. So Frontier's gonna get the ball back, throw into Molly Gates.
Yeah, you just see how fast these throw-ins are.
Look at that. There's also been a couple of times, Aiden, where they've had these foot races up the sideline, and Frontier's won a decent amount of them.
A lot of stamina.
Oh yeah. You know, it's like they're running all over the field, and then when they need to sprint, they can sprint. And they can beat most of the Green Wave players, too.
My only concern with that is, are they going to get too tired before the second half?
Yeah, that's a very fair point. I mean, like, we've got 8.5 minutes left in this first half, and then we've got another 40 minutes of play after a short intermission in between halves.
Seems like Greenfield's conserving the energy while Frontier is putting all they have.
Yeah, that's a very interesting point. Green Wave could be trying to make a comeback, like planning for a comeback in the second half. Frontier's got another opportunity to score here, putting a lot of pressure in the goalie box right now, but it's going to get knocked out. Claire McFarland passed to Fosno. Pass back to Fosno. He's going to try to get it to the far side of the field. Gets intercepted. Fosno back with the ball. Makes a nice move there. Shot on goal from a little ways away. Gets caught by the goalie. Punted back to midfield. And Esmina's going to get the ball off of the punt. Gets kicked away. Molly Gates gets it, passes it back. Pass up by Green Wave. No one's there, so Anna Petrin's going to get it. Pass it back. Fosno. Fagan has it now. Pass up. She's all alone. Takes a shot, and it's in. There's Frontier's fourth goal of the night.
Another well passed through ball.
And
if they keep doing this, it's going to be a good night for Frontier.
That was Kylie LaFord, I believe, if I'm not mistaken. So Frontier has scored four times in this first half, folks. And they are showing no signs of slowing down, which, of course, spells bad news for Green Wave if they don't change something. And you know, if I could give some advice to Green Wave right now, it would be that their defenders need to be more alert in those situations, because there's been a couple of times, I think twice now, where Frontier's gotten a goal off of like a fast break situation.
Goal scored by Kylie LaFord.
Yes, definitely.
And you know, the Frontier players gotten past, like sprinted past the defenders. The defenders have been closer to the ball and they just got beat. And you know, whether or not that's because they're tired, it's like, you know, I'm sure that they've got their own excuses, but at the end of the day, it's like, you know, you're going to try and want to win the game. And
for sure.
If you can't beat your opponent to the ball, you can't do that. Ooh, jeez.
That was some hard contact there.
Yeah. You'd hear the crowd groan. Levante looks to be all right, though, standing up in the goalie box. Pass up to Green Wave, tries to make a move, gets by Anna Petrand, is in the corner now, looking for a centering pass. They're going to pass it back a bit, but it's going to get intercepted by Frontier. Passed up and out of bounds. So it's going to be a Green Wave throw-in. Nice long throw-in there. But just over the head of Esmina, so she's not going to be able to get it, which no doubt is what Green Wave wanted. Fagan with the ball now for Frontier. Tor passes it up past the defenders, and Molly Gates is going to try and get it. And Green Wave is just going to kick it out of bounds again. Couple subs coming in, it looks like, for Frontier.
I noticed Frontier has the amount of players when they can just keep subbing, but Greenfield only has two subs, it seems like.
Oh, yeah, you're right. I didn't notice that. That would also explain Frontier's strategy of trying to tire them out. Looks like their shoes got caught up over there.
Yeah, I don't know if you saw that. Looks like they tripped themselves or something.
Fagan with the ball. Top of the goalie box for Frontier. Tries to pass it up. No one's there. Shot on goal, just over the crossbar. Nice effort there by Frontier. Asmani is going to try and make a play, passes it forward. There's no one there. Anna Petron's going to try and clear it, get stopped. Green Wave player Ava Widello is going to try and chase it down. There's a throw-in by Green Waves in the middle of the field. Asmina's going to get it. Long shot on goal. Gets caught right out of the air by Robinson. And the crowd, folks, just all stood up. They're cheering for Robinson because that, I believe, is her 100th save of the season.
What a big accomplishment.
That is quite impressive.
She's got a very good boot with her foot.
Oh, yeah.
She kicked that ball all the way across the field.
Fosno in the goalie box tries to pass it up to Fagan, but a little bit too far. It's going to go out of bounds.
So that was her 100th save?
I believe so, yes. Based on the crowd's reaction, I'd say so.
I'll say so, too.
And they were talking about it earlier in the game. They've got a bunch of signs, a couple of balloons in the crowd, so that'd be my best bet. Gates in the corner tries to make something happen, but it's going to go out of bounds. Stays Frontier's ball. Here's a throw-in to Fagan. Gets right by her, but LaFord's there. I believe it's LaFord. Tries to be cleared by Green Wave defender, and it is out to the far sideline. McFarland's there for Frontier, though. Tries to kick it back up. And Widello's there. Pass to Osmani. Gets kicked back to Fagan. On the Redhawks. Pass up to LaFord, who's got a little room here to work with, but it's going to get kicked out of bounds.
Got some subs coming in.
Yeah. So that's going to Victoria Levitsky and let's see who else came on.
Number three, I believe.
Yeah, that was Levitsky.
And it was that 3 and 18.
3 and 18. Who's 18? Let's check our roster here. Holly Babineau. Those two just subbed in for Green Wave. Nice little chip shot on goal right there.
Amazing cross.
That's another thing that Frontier's just really shown they're great at in this game. The cross passes right into the center of the goalie box. Gives them just some great opportunities. So Green Wave putting some pressure on Robinson now, getting the ball pretty close. And that's Widello, I believe. No, it's not. It's my bad. Widello has the ball now. That ball's going to get passed back to center field. Midfield. Fagan has the ball on the far sideline. Looking for a pass. There's LaFord. Crossfield pass to Bennett. Going to get taken by Green Wave. And there's Eldarina, who's Asmina's sister, I guess. And
seems like a timeout.
Nope. That's
halftime.
That's the half, I believe, folks. All right, that's the first half of this girls' soccer game, senior night here at Frontier. Frontier is leading the game 4-1. And we are going to take a quick break in between halves as the players take a break too. We'll be back in a few minutes. You're watching Frontier Community Access Television. Hello and welcome back to Frontier Community Access Television. Second half of the girls' varsity soccer game is underway right now. Thank you for sticking with us on this wonderful chilly evening.
Very chilly evening.
I'm still your host, Mason Smith, still joined by Aiden Weiss. Got Alec Eckel, Desmond, and the rest of the FCAT crew here helping us film this. And if you're just joining us, the score is 4-1. Frontier is in the lead against Green Wave. And Green Wave has the ball right now, pushing it forward into the goalie box. And Widello is going to get knocked down as she tries to make a play, and ball's going to go out of bounds. So it's going to be a goal kick. Anna Petron, I believe, is going to take that. Yeah, that's Anna Petron. So we've got a second half starting now, so that's 40-minute half, for those of you who aren't familiar. I'm right there with you. Frontier trying to push the ball forward. Pass to Fosno gets intercepted. She gets the ball back. Passes it back to a defender. Nice little triangle there. Fosno racing up the sideline. She's going to beat her defender to the ball. Gets into the goalie box. but the defender's going to take it away from her. Goes back up the sideline. Centering pass by Frontier. And the shot's going to get scooped up by Green Wave's goalie and thrown out to Asmina. Crossfield pass by Kylie LaFord. Green Wave defender gets knocked down in the process. Shot on goal by LaFord over a couple defenders is caught out of the air by Valente. Low kick on the ground.
Doesn't seem like she was happy with that kick.
Yeah. And now Asmina has the ball, passes it forward past Frontier defenders. Patron's going to race to get it. Whistle's blown. I think it was a handball. Didn't look intentional, though. Looks like she kicked it and then just hit her hand. Petrin with the kick. And that's Eldarina who gets it. And Robinson's going to fall on top of the ball, stopping any progress that Green Wave just made. Sends it out to midfield. Fosno passes it up. Bennett with the ball now for Frontier. Crossfield pass. Ooh. Kick by Tor there gets taken right in the face by a Green Wave defender. Frontier pushes the ball up. Ball gets passed back. That's Fosno with the ball now. Tries to push it forward. Gets through a couple defenders. LaFord has it. And Fagan gets a shot right over the goal. Well, it's officially nighttime here now at Frontier Regional. We've got the lights shining down on all of us and the players.
Nice scenery.
Oh yeah, that's for sure. Got a lot of nice, pretty fall colors here for this game. Wish it was a little warmer though.
Yeah.
Tor with the ball. Pass to Mackin. LaFord fights for possession, and it's going to get sent back by a Green Wave player, passed back by a Frontier defender, and as Mina's going to get it, takes it up center field, pass forward, gets kicked down by Petrin, and Mackin's going to send it across midfield, gets sent right back by a Greenfield defender, and Fosno's going to be right there. She's going to take the ball from the defender. Pushes it up the field. Centers the pass to Fagan. Fagan's fighting for the ball right in the goalie box, right in front of the goalie. And now Fosno's trying to get the ball back. She does. Pass there to Bennett, LaFord. And the shot's just wide of the goal. Valente. Little goalie kick to Asmina. Good footwork there. Passes it long way down the field. Petrin's going to get to it first for Frontier. Tries to send it back, but Green Wave's right there for it. Petrin gets it back. Sends it down to midfield. There's Bennett. Pass to Fosno. Back to Bennett. Makes a move around the defenders. She's in a foot race now. Oh, and they're both going to get tripped up.
Very unfortunate.
A loss of momentum there for Frontier. They had something going. Centering pass scooped up by Valente.
I've noticed Bennett has a lot of speed, so she can win those foot races a lot.
Oh, yeah. No, she's won pretty much all of them, I think. Good call by the ref there. Barely went out of bounds, but he was right there. So Frontier gets the throw-in, gets knocked down. Bennett to Fosno. Knocked back to Bennett. Fosno with it now to Tor. Sydney Tor. Pass up, and it goes right past a couple defenders, right to Valente, who scoops it up and kicks it out to midfield. Anna Petron's going to head it, and it's going to go out of bounds. Off of the green wave forward, so Frontier gets the throw-in. Fagan, off of the throw-in, makes a couple moves, trips up her defender a bit. Backtracks, pass to Tor. Fosno racing for the ball. Gets it from her defender. Pass to Mackin. Mackin makes a nice move to Fagan in the middle of the goalie box. Shot on goal's good. And that is Frontier's fifth goal of the night, first of this second half, and Madeline Fagan's second goal of the night, which I believe, yeah, Madeline Fagan is only in ninth grade on the varsity team and has two goals tonight.
I think she's the youngest one on the team, if I'm correct. Oh, that's playing.
Yeah, youngest
right now.
youngest one playing. They've got a couple eighth graders that they've gotten reserves.
That goal was bottom left corner. Nothing really much the goalie could do there.
Yeah. On the opposite side, too.
Just overall, a great goal.
And you know what? What you saw leading up to that is what you want to see leading up to every good goal. A lot of passing from all of the forwards and midfielders. I think I said just about everyone's name at least once on that play.
Goal scored by Maddie Fagan.
So Frontier is going to get a throw-in on the near sideline. Gates tries to make something happen, but it's going to get punted back by a Green Wave player. Frontier defender's right there. Green Wave's going to try and make something happen. Centering pass gets kicked back to Sydney Tor. And kicked out of bounds by Frontier. So as Mina's going to get the ball off a soft throw-in. What a kick there, my God.
Powerful leg.
To no one in particular, though. But that was...
You know, sometimes you just gotta show off that power you have. Every now and then, just gotta show off a bit.
Yeah, I mean... The thing that I think they've gotta think... That Green Wave has to think about right now with... just under half an hour left in this game. They're down 4 goals, and the only person that seems to be doing a lot on their team is Asmina. And there are so many people on the field in soccer, Aiden. And, you know, at that point, it's like you can't really have a one-person offense, you know?
It's very much a team sport.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Very
much. There's certain sports where it's like you can have one really good player that can more or less carry the rest of the team, like when there's not a lot of other people.
Kind of like golf is an independent game almost.
You know? And like with football, like it doesn't make a great team, but you can have like one or two pairs or like a couple really good receivers and a good quarterback, and you can make it pretty far. But with soccer, if you just have one or two good players, that's not going to do all that much for you once those two players get tired, you know?
Yeah, you need everybody working, being on the same page, all communicating to each other.
Yeah.
Need that team chemistry.
That's very true. And, you know, the kind of things that build that are, like, you know, team dinners, just hanging out outside of practice, that kind of thing, and just really getting to know each other.
Yes.
So, you know, because there's definitely a difference, and you can see it when teams are playing. There's a difference between a team and a family, you know? Because when you're out there and you see them just passing it amongst each other and they know where everyone's going to be, they've practiced it a lot, but also they just know the other players and they know where they're going to be and they know where they want to be.
They understand each other more.
Yeah.
Unlike other teams where they could be arguing, which just doesn't help them out.
Yeah. And no, you can point to, like, Greenfield's star player right now. I keep forgetting their name. As Mina. Sorry, folks. Like, Greenfield's star player right now is Mina. You know, they're making some great plays out there. They've got some incredible footwork. But then, you know, you also see them, you know, shouting at other players. And at the end of the day, you know, that isn't what you want. You know, you want to have that team community. You want to have that team spirit. You don't want it to be one person's team. And I think that, you know, you can point to a lot of the, you know, technical, like logistical things and the physical things that each team is doing. But I think that really right now what's really killing Greenfield is that they just don't have that same feeling of community. Anyway, after my little tangent there, let's get back to the action on the field.
Got carried away a bit.
Yeah. How long did we talk for?
Okay.
All right, ball's going to go out of bounds on Green Wave, so Frontier throw-in. To Mackin, pass to Tor.
Move it!
He's going to get... pass off to Gates. And little action on the sideline there is going to go out on Green Wave. Throw in is to Gates. Centering pass. Right in the middle of the goalie box. Gates is there looking for something. Tor has the ball now, fighting for it against Asmina. Little pop fly pass there. Jillian Warden fighting for the ball right now for Frontier. Tor intercepts a pass, almost goes out of bounds. Asmina is fighting for it right now for Green Wave. And the refs are going to blow the whistle.
Do you know what that call was on?
I don't know. That's a... my first thought was a reaching foul, but that's basketball, unless there is a reaching foul in soccer that I'm not aware of, which very well could be true. I don't watch a lot of soccer. And now we're getting some subs in. They're going to bring in... that's Jocelyn Antes for Frontier. And pretty sure that was Amelia Gray is the new player in for Green Wave. Ball's going to be in midfield. Claire McFarland is going to try and make a play. Passes it up to Mackin, who brings it up the field. Pass to Warden. Tries to center it. Gets by a couple defenders, but is stopped. Antes picks up the ball. Jocelyn Antes dribbles around for a bit. Passes to Tor. Tor gets a shot, and the goalie is going to scoop it up just to the left of the goal. Shorter punt there to Asmina. Gets surrounded by two Frontier players. Is going to do a nice long throw in, but it's just too far for number 17. That's Indy Merrill. And that's another thing I've been noticing about Asmina, specifically with throw-ins. She does the throw-ins deep, she does her kicks deep, and it's always to that side, to Indy Merrill's side, number 17, closest to us. And it's always just a little bit too far, and she can't get to it. And I'm not knocking Asmina at all, but...
Yeah.
Anna Petrin with a little header to knock it down. Asmina with the ball. Makes a couple moves around defenders. Passes it up between two defenders. And Petrin makes a nice move there. Keeps the ball. And there's Warden. Pass to Mackin, who... Ball's going to get knocked out of bounds by Green Wave. Throw-ins to Antes. Tries to make a move around a couple defenders. Gets swarmed. Green Wave defender gets the ball. And Antes blocks the pass. It's going to get it.
We've got a whistle blown.
Yeah, that's going to be a timeout.
We had a sub and a timeout at the same time. Got a little confused there.
Yeah. All right, so the players are going to take a quick timeout, and so will we. You are watching Frontier Community Access Television. Hello, and welcome back to Frontier Community Access Television. We have about 21 minutes left in the second half of girls soccer matchup, Frontier versus Green Wave. Frontier's up 5-1. We're just back from a quick little timeout. And Frontier has the ball right now. Shot over the crossbar right there by Hannah Mackin, I believe.
I also believe they substituted for Greenfield number 3, Victoria, I believe.
I think that you're right, yeah. Yeah, Victoria Levitsky.
Yes, she went in... during the timeout, I believe.
Yeah.
If I'm not mistaken.
He was waiting on the sideline before. Greenfield throwing over Warden's head to Asmina. She's going to push around McFarland there. Make a move. Try and get past her defender. Passes to her sister at midfield. Gets intercepted by McFarland. Torres the ball now. Pass up to Mackin, to Gates. Both of them, Gates and her defender, fall down, and then they get right back up. Play resumes. Greenwave intercepts a pass. And the ball's going to go out of bounds on Greenwave. Frontier gets a throw-in to Gates. Pass back to Mackin. Pass up and back. And there's Warden with the ball now. Gets kicked back by a Green Wave defender. Passed up to Asmina, who makes a move around her defender, but the ball's going to go out of bounds. Asmina intercepts a throw-in and the ball is going to be in center field now. Good opportunity for Green Wave. Let's see if they can make something happen. As Mina pass up, gets intercepted by Petrin, who's going to pass it to Warden on the sideline. And she's going to lose handle of the ball. It's going to go out of bounds. So throw in to Asmina.
Asmina is doing a lot of footwork and
oh yeah,
fancy.
That's for sure. She's getting the ball a lot, but
yeah.
You know, she's the stuff that she's doing is impressive. Don't get me wrong, but you know, she's not really doing a lot, quite honestly. Like in terms of like getting the ball where it needs to be for Green Wave.
Oh, I totally agree.
Because, I mean, she's kicking it forward towards the goalie box. But is there anyone there to get the pass? No, there's not. And, you know, at the end of the day, it's like, you know, anyone can get that pass up there. But what you really need is to have someone up there so you can have the nice little assist that Frontier's had so many times, which is why they're up 5-1 right now. Gates with the ball for Frontier. Pushes it up into the goalie box. Antes with the shot on goal. Gets caught out of the air by Valente. Asmina. Nice little scoop pass. Frontier back with the ball now. And that's Caroline Crocker, who just made that pass. Green Wave gets the ball back. Tor heads it forward for Frontier. And Warden gets it now. Pass up to Antes on the sideline. Lets it go by her, but she can't reach in time before it goes out of bounds. Now, I don't know about you, Aiden, but I'm still... We've been doing this game for... What is it? More than like an hour now. But I'm still having trouble calling that out of bounds because I'm used to calling the football games where the out of bounds is just the white line.
Oh, yeah. That's definitely messing with me, too.
Yeah, because they're right there, and it's like that little area where part of me wants to say, and the ball's out of bounds, and they're just playing it anyway.
Yeah.
But then it's like, no, it's the blue line.
Messes with your head definitely a lot.
Yeah, especially for you, I'd imagine, as a football player. But there's
especially the goalie box. It's very hard to see from this angle.
No, especially... Oh, nice save there by Valenti.
That was a good save.
Popped it up right over the crossbar. So we've got 16 minutes left in this game. 16, not 60. And
got me scared for a second.
Yeah. Frontier leading by 4 goals. So hope is really starting to dwindle now for Green Wave. And if they don't get a couple goals within the next few minutes here, I think that... You know, it's just going to seal the deal for them, really.
You know what I'm seeing a lot? Frontier, they're up by 4 goals, and yet they're still pushing a lot and just still trying to get goals. I would have thought they would have tried to stay on defense and just command and stay and just hold their ground. But no, they keep pushing.
There's a corner kick from Frontier. Gets headed out of the goalie box. Pass back to Frontier defender. Gates has the ball now. Pass up goes right over Warden's head. Gates pass to Warden. Has it in the center of the field now. And there's a nice boot there by Asmina. Let's see if Green Wave can do anything with this opportunity. And there's a penalty called right there. That's a good call by the ref. It's very clearly a push. No, but see, that's one of the rare opportunities one of the rare instances in this game where I've seen Asmina do a good setup. Throwing for Frontier on the near sideline.
Got some subs coming in.
Oh my goodness. We have reached 44 degrees here, folks, and I can't feel my toes.
I cannot feel my toes either, and I'm just wearing slides.
Gates gets the ball past a couple defenders. Shot on goal goes just wide. Oh, that's a great effort there.
Seemed like she just got a little tripped up.
A little applause from Desmond. Always deserved. Goalie kick gets fielded by LaFord. Pass to Warden. Makes a move on her defender. Is she going to get by? They're still fighting for her. She's going to pass back to LaFord. And there's a pass cross field to Fosno, but it's going to get intercepted.
I just want to say something real quick.
Yeah.
Some of the Frontier players just got mad real quick because one of the Greenfield waves, when they were on the ground, they were playing with the ball, and legally you're not supposed to do that.
That's a good point. I mean, the refs didn't call it, so...
I'm just...
What's that called? Like, dangerous play or
yeah,
something
that's like dangerous
that?
Play, yeah. Playing on the ground, something like that. But I just noticed some of them yelling at the refs. And
yeah, yeah. I mean, again, I don't know soccer penalties all that well, but they haven't been calling a lot of penalties. Mostly it's just been like, you know, the basic stuff, like just like, you know, offsides or handballs and that sort of thing. But we haven't seen a lot of like actual like real like, you know, yellow card level like penalties
yeah.
or anything like that. I don't think we've even... Do they have yellow cards and red cards in
yes.
this?
Yes, yellow and red level? Cards, yes.
Alright.
I mean, I would imagine.
Yeah, that's what I would think. Shot on goal. Oh my goodness, right off the crossbar. The post, my bad. And Jocelyn Antes is going to get the rebound. Oh, but it went out of bounds, I think.
Very, very close.
Oh, I see what happened. So the Green Wave goalie blocked the shot, and it went out of bounds. So now it's a Frontier corner kick.
Must have just hit her fingertips.
Ooh. Look at this. Here we go. We've got a Green Wave player taking it all the way past midfield before finally passing it. That was Eldarina. Great effort there. Wow. Antes gets a centering pass. Fosno. LaFord with the ball now. Tries to pass up to Gates. Gets intercepted. Kicked back. And there's Gates, gets tripped up in the box.
Ooh.
Oh, and Green Wave players struggling to get up. Looks like they're stretching.
Some people aren't too happy about that.
Yeah. Either they're not too happy or they're concerned about that player because they looked like they were in a bit of pain.
Oh, yes, definitely.
But here's Warden on the near sideline. Gets past her defender. Green Wave kicks it back. Ball gets popped up. Fielded by the Red Hawks. And McDermott's going to take it up. Pass to Gates. Shot on goal. Oh, goes right in front of him. Out of bounds on the baseline. think that's what they call it. Maybe that's just basketball. I don't know. What do I know anymore?
I mean, I think, yeah, let's just stick to baseline.
Yeah, let's stick with that. I mean, it's got to be different than the sideline, right? Because it's not on the side.
Yeah. Number 14 came in, and number 6, so.
As Mina gets the ball taken from her by LaFord. LaFord passed to Gates. Back to LaFord in the center. Tries to take a shot, gets blocked. Good defense there by Green Wave. Pass back to LaFord. Gets intercepted by Green Wave. Looks like Frontier's going to get it back, though. Yes, Molly Gates has it. Centering pass just by the goalie, and it's going to roll out of bounds.
Out at the baseline.
Yeah, I got that right. Goal kick gets fielded by Asmina. Nice. Some really impressive footwork here from Asmina. And there's the pass we've been looking for all night. She's got a little bit of room to work with. Number 17, Indy Morrell. She's going to get knocked down, though. And before she can get up, it's going to get cleared by a Frontier defender. That's the closest that Green Wave has gotten to a goal in a long time in this game.
Almost this whole half.
Yeah, and you know, that is exactly what we've been talking about, and that's the kind of stuff that, you know, Frontier's been showing all game, and that's the kind of stuff that Green Wave needs to be showing, that they needed to be showing if they wanted to be in a position to take the lead right now. But, you know, we've only got 7 minutes left. At this point, it's going to take a miracle for them to win this game. But they're in scoring position right now. And they get a little tripped up right at the end. Great effort, though, by Merrill. So with just under 7 minutes here left in this game, Frontier still ahead 5-1.
Greenwave needs to do something here if they want to have a chance to win.
Pass up to Gates, gets intercepted. Fagan with the ball to LaFord. Pass up by Greenwave, headed back by Frontier. Over Fosno's head. Fagan with the ball now. Pass up in front of all the defenders. Goalie's running up to grab it, and she gets there first. Looking for a good place to kick. There it is. And she's going to get it past her player. And Frontier's going to kick it back out of bounds. And we've got a sub. That's number 13, Taylor Bergeron, coming in for Amelia Gray on Green Wave. Green Wave throwing, knocked down by Antes. Tries to pass it to Bennett, but it's going to get knocked out of bounds. Another Green Wave throwing. Petron's going to pass it forward, past LaFord. LaFord doesn't get there in time. The ball gets past Fagan to Merrill, who's going to pass it to her teammate right next to her. Frontier's going to get the ball back to Fosno. Green Wave. Asmina has the ball now. Got a little bit of room to work with now. Gets to the goalie box. Tries to take a shot. It gets blocked. Merrill with a chance.
Oh.
Did that go in? They've got opportunities here. Robinson's on the ground. I thought that shot went in.
It just hit the top of the crossbar and went straight down. Never went past the line.
How often do you see that?
Let me tell you, not that very often.
I could have sworn that went in. I thought I saw like the net move and everything. Wow. Anyway, Fagan's got the ball now for Frontier in the far corner. Gates with a shot. Goes just over the net. and we've got 4 minutes left now. That was, oh my God, that was really close. And past that initial shot where I hit the crossbar and just went straight down, it didn't go in. Robinson was just on the ground. And
the ball still didn't go in.
They were still trying to get it in, and they had Frontier had a couple defenders around the goal. And that was quite an impressive and astonishing play. As Mina making a move, gets around two or three defenders there, trying to get past one more, takes a shot off of Robinson, centering pass, can't get the shot off. And Frontier's going to get the ball back. Kylie LaFour taking it past midfield. Pass up to Fagan on the far sideline, moving it in. There's a shot, and it's in! Oh my God!
What a goal!
What an incredible shot by Fagan. That is her third goal tonight,
folks. That's a hat trick. What a goal!
Madeline Fagan, freshman, just got a hat trick on senior night, folks. That is something else. Oh my goodness. And that
was an amazing goal.
If the game wasn't already over, it is now. The score is 6-1 Frontier with just under 3 minutes left. Of course, we're going to see an effort from Green Wave. Hopefully they can get a goal or two here, but I just can't.
Goal scored by Maddie Fagan.
Scoring 5 goals to tie this up at the end. Even get a tie out of this. Because they don't have overtime, I don't think so.
Nope, yeah, no overtime.
They don't have overtime. And see, again, Frontier's just pushed the ball up to the goalie box. They got a shot on goal. As Mina trying to make a move, but the ball's going to go just out of bounds, and it's a Frontier throw-in. To Tor. Pass up to Bennett. To LaFord. He's going to pass it back. Gets intercepted by Eldarina, who's going to try and take it up the field. She's got Anna Petrin on her. Tries to make a move around her, but she can't. Petrin stops her. Kicks the ball up the sideline. It's going to go out of bounds. So it's a Green Wave throw-in to Merrill, who isn't going to be able to keep it in bounds. So it's going to be a goal kick for Frontier. And Anna Petrin's going to take the goal kick once again. Nice strong kick there to Kylie LaFord. Gets tripped up a bit. Going to get the ball back to Jocelyn Antes. And Bennett's there and is going to kick it out of bounds. As Mina, little header to get it over a defender. Pass up to Sydney Tor from Petrin. Pass past the defenders. Bennett's there looking for it. Antes looking for a shot. She's going to get it, but it gets stopped. Nice save there by Valenti.
Good save.
Valenti. Looks like the clock's stopped, and that's the game. Clock stopped at 2 minutes, but that's going to be the end of the game, folks. Final is 6-1 Frontier. So that's going to be their 9th win of the season. An incredible season so far for Frontier Girls Varsity Soccer. And it was really just an incredible game overall. We had a hat trick from a freshman.
A freshman, that's very impressive.
It wasn't just little, you know, it was a great assist and then a little chip shot in. Like that last goal, that was beautiful. Right over the goalie's head. That's the kind of stuff that you see in like professional soccer like highlight reels.
Yeah.
That was a pretty shot right there.
That by itself is amazing, but she also scored two other goals in this game. Two other goals.
And so Madeline Fagan by herself is going to account for half of the goals that Frontier has scored tonight. And so as the players line up and high-five each other, we're going to try and wrap things up so we can go home.
On this very cold night.
Yeah, very, very cold night. We hope that you all are at home warmer than we are. But this has been a great season so far for Frontier. This game specifically was phenomenal. Great team effort. And Aiden, any last thoughts before we go?
I mean, great game overall. Good senior night.
Oh, yeah.
And, yeah. Overall, great game. Thanks for joining IFCAT.
Yeah, thank you for joining us tonight, everyone. This has been Mason Smith, Aiden Weiss, Desmond, Alec Eckel, all the rest of the IFCAT crew. And we're going to call it a night. Thank you for tuning in to Frontier Community Access Television.